Good afternoon, students, and welcome back in our second session of absorption of water. In last lecture, we have already seen the properties of water and role of water into the plant life. Okay, now before seeing the mechanism of water absorption, we'll see the actual structure of the root. When we see the structure of root, it has presence of three separate zone. The uppermost, or the part which is present towards the tip of the root, is called as meristematic region. It is the main growing region of the root. And in front of this root, there is presence of one protective structure called as root cap. Behind the meristematic region, there is presence of zone of elongation, and behind zone of elongation there is presence of root hair zone. The absorption of water mainly takes place through root hair zones, and which is immersed into the soil. Root hairs are mainly epidermal projections and which are tubular hair like structures. Mainly these are permeable, semi-permeable, and consist with pectic and cellulosic substances which are hydrophilic in nature. And these roots are absorbing only one type of water which is present within the soil, is capillary water. The capillary water is a water which remains in the soil after draining of gravitational water. It forms a thin film around the soil grain. And remember, it is the only water which can be absorbed by the plant. See, this capillary water is nothing but the moisture held within the tiny spaces between the soil particles. Or simply, we can say the adsorbed water molecule over the soil particle. You can see in the diagram, between the tiny particles of the soil, the water molecule which are folded are known as the capillary water. Okay, and this capillary water can be absorbed by the plant. Okay, so we'll start actually the mechanism of absorption of water. The mechanism of absorption of water can be explained by two theories: active absorption theory and passive absorption theory. Mainly, the mechanism of active absorption of water is explained by the two theories again: osmotic theory of absorption of water and non-osmotic theory of water absorption. And the passive absorption of water is also explaining the mechanism of absorption of water. Now we'll see one by one the theory for absorption of water. The first one is osmotic theory of absorption of water. As the name indicates, the theory is totally based upon the phenomenon of osmosis. Now, what is this osmosis? In FYBSC, we have already studied the physiological processes like osmosis. Now, what is this osmosis? Osmosis is a movement of solvent molecule, that is water molecule, via semi-permeable membrane from solution of lower concentration to the solution of higher concentration. Okay, means when we separating the two different solution of a different concentration via semi-permeable membrane, the movement of water molecule is always takes place from the low concentrated solution to the high concentrated solution. And this movement of water molecule is creating some category of pressure, and that pressure is known as the osmotic pressure. And this osmotic pressure is mainly formed due to difference in osmotic pressure. Difference in concentration of the solution. Now, mainly when we are thinking about the root cell and the soil water, there is difference of osmotic pressure between these two. The osmotic cell having more osmotic pressure as compared to soil water. Now, as there is more amount of osmotic pressure of the cell wall, root cell, which means that the concentration of solution or concentration of cell sap is more as compared to soil water. And in this condition, there is process of endosmosis. Means the water molecule get entered within the root cell and leads to increase in turgor pressure of the root cell. Now, this increased root cell's turgor pressure leads to decrease in osmotic pressure of the root cell. Okay, and due to decrease in osmotic pressure of the root cell, there is again, when we compare the osmotic pressure of the root cell with nearby cortical cell, there is formation of a potential difference. Okay, the root pressure, the root cell having less osmotic pressure as compared to cortical cell. So that again, there is movement of water molecule from the root cell to the corticular cell. We'll see it diagrammatically. In this diagram, you can see the soil. Within the soil, there is presence of root hair which is emerged from the epidermal cell. Now, this root hair cell having higher osmotic pressure, which leads to absorption of water from the soil. Now, due to absorption of water, there is increase in turgor pressure of this root hair, leads to decrease in the osmotic pressure. Now, if we compare this root hair cell with the cortical cell, then the osmotic pressure of this cortical cell is more. So that there is movement of water molecule from the epidermal cell to the cortical cell. Now, when there is movement of water molecule from epidermis to the cortex, cortical cell, there is again decrease in osmotic pressure of the cortical cell as compared to neighboring cortical cell. So again, there is movement of water molecule from the cortical cell to the innermost corticular cell. Then again, towards the inner cortical cell, and this flow of water is reaches to the xylem via epidermis and pericycle. The difference in osmotic pressure leads to movement of water molecule from root hair to the xylem cell. And from this xylem cell, it is equally distributed over all the plant. Okay, we can see again in a flashback, the water molecule are absorbed within the root cell, are get transferred towards the cortex cell, then from cortex to innermost cortex to endodermis, and finally reaches up to the xylem, and this whole movement of water is guarded by difference in osmotic pressure. This is the mechanism of absorption of water explained by the osmotic absorption of water. But this theory is not universally accepted. This theory are having some objections. Mainly, when scientists have calculated the amount of this root pressure, it is very, very low and it is not sufficient to transfer water molecule or to absorb water molecule within the very tall plants. Again, the development of root pressure is not a universal phenomenon. It is not observed within the all plants, all genus, all species, etc. And mainly, the absorption can also take place in absence of root also. So, as there is absence of root, there is no question of development of osmotic potential or osmotic pressure. For example, if we cut a branch of plant and if we place that branch of plant within the glass of water, then also there is absorption of water, which proves that for the absorption of water, there is no requirement of root cell. Okay, so due to this reasons, the osmotic theory of water absorption is not accepted full-fledged. And therefore, at that time, there was another scientist named as Cramer proposed another theory for the absorption of water is non-osmotic theory for the absorption of water. Now, as a name indicate, there was no connection between absorption of water and the osmosis. This theory mainly considered that there is movement of water molecule from soil to root to the top of plant against the concentration gradient, against the gravity, and we know that the work which is performed against the concentration gradient is always requires a lot amount of energy, and here the energy is utilized in the form of ATP. Okay, so this theory considered that the active absorption is always takes place on the basis of use of energy. It depends upon the amount of ATP available for the process of absorption of water. It doesn't consider any principle of the osmotic pressure. There are some supporting evidences which also supports this link of ATP utilization to the absorption of water. Now we know that in which process there is liberation of ATP molecule? In the respiration, there is liberation of energy in the form of ATP, and these ATPs are utilized for the process of absorption. When scientists have studied the rate of absorption and rate of respiration, they found a close link between the absorption and respiration. If the respiration is inhibited, absorption is also inhibited, and therefore it proves that for the absorption there is requirement of energy. At the same time, the factors affecting to the respiration are also affecting the rate of absorption of water also, and the poisonous substances like cyanides, which have a capacity to retard the respiration, are also retarding the process of absorption of water. And therefore, this proves that the non-osmotic theory is also working or is also explaining the mechanism of absorption of water molecule by utilizing the lot many amount of energy which is liberated in the process of respiration. Okay, now these are the two theories based on the active absorption of water, in which the root cells are actively taking part within the process of absorption of water. Nextly, we'll see the theory of absorption of water, in which there is root cells are acting as only medium. They are not directly involved in the absorption of water molecule, and therefore this theory is named as passive absorption of water. Now, within this passive absorption of water, the root cell always remain passive, and there is generation of some another kind of forces which are responsible for the absorption of water. This type of forces are generally generated into the leaves of the plant, and which are important for the absorption of water molecule. Mainly, the leaves are the main organ of process of transpiration. Transpiration is a process of loss of water molecule via plant aerial plant parts in the form of vapor. Okay, and this process of transpiration is mainly involved in the passive absorption of water. The transpiration creates a tension into the xylem cells of the leaves, and these created tension is important for the absorption of water. Initially, the tension is created within the xylem cells of leaves, and then it is transmitted up to the xylem of the root, which leads to formation of a continuous column within the plant, and this column is used, or it generally creating a force which is responsible for sucking of water from the soil to the root hairs, and from root hairs it is transmitted up to the xylem. Okay, and within this whole process the root cell remain as it is passive, therefore it is called as the passive absorption of water. Mainly there are some evidences which are proving the passive absorption theory are absorption and transpiration are closely linked with each other. Always rate of absorption and rate of transpiration is always equal. They are always directly proportional to each other, and as absorption takes place without root also, it is a complete evidence which proves that transpiration is involved into the absorption instead of root. We know that the cut branch of stem also absorbing the water, which proves that the absorption of water is directly depend upon the rate of transpiration. Okay, now if we see within this diagram, we can see a xylem is present at the center of the leaf, and the number of stomata are present towards the lower side of the leaf. In some cases the stomata are also present on the upper leaf, but these are generally less in number. Now this stomata goes for the transpiration, creating a tension within the xylem cells of the leaves. This created pressure within the xylem cells of the leaves are transferred towards the stem, and from stem to the root cells xylem. This tension is going to create a continuous pull, continuous column, and it is also called as transpiration pull. This transpiration, the tension which is created by this transpiration, it leads to absorption of water via root cells, and therefore it is nothing but the mechanism of absorption of water which is totally based upon the rate of transpiration. Okay, now this is about the mechanism of absorption of water. We have seen that there are three theories, actually mainly two theories, active absorption and passive absorption. Active absorption is explained by the osmotic theory and non-osmotic theory, while passive absorption is mainly linked with the transpiration. Okay, in next lecture we'll see the factors affecting the process of absorption of water. These are some references which I used for this lecture. Thank you so much. If you have any query, you can ask me on my mail, or you can ask in the Google Classroom. Okay, thank you.